Hello everybody, my name is Jade, and welcome to this video. The last video had over 400 views. What the actual? I am so thankful, grateful, and happy with it from the bottom of my heart. Thank you everybody. Thank you for sharing, for watching, for liking, and for subscribing. In this video, I'm going to do a general update. I am going to talk about my weight and my weight loss progress, and I'm going to talk about names for trans people and why names matter. Before we get going, don't click away yet. Have you considered subscribing? Because most of the people that watch these videos aren't actually subscribed. See the graph that I have here. It would be really helpful for me if you subscribed. It pushes my videos higher through the algorithm and it makes it easier for my videos to be found and seen by others. So please think about it. Subscribe button is down below. Let's start off with the general update. I am feeling really well. I am doing good. I'm in a good place and I'm actually feeling really happy at this point. The hormones are still doing their work, as is visible thanks to the new lens angle. They're still working. I don't have that many side effects. I notice at the end of every month when I need to get my T blockers that I am a little bit more emotional and that my hormones are a little bit off the charts. But besides that, everything is going really well and I'm in a really stable place right now. The past month I've had the reality check that I will have to start saving up for body hair laser removal. Because yes, the hormones have definitely helped. My hairs have thinned out, but the volume, the amount hasn't changed that much. And I definitely want to get rid of it because it's my biggest source of dysphoria. When I look in the mirror, all I can see is a hairy mess and I want to get rid of that. So I should start saving up on that. Because whereas in the Netherlands, facial hair removal is covered under your health insurance, body hair isn't. And that's all because of a certain way of thinking. They think you should be able to exude femininity to the outside world, but what you have under your clothes, that doesn't really matter, that isn't covered. Which I think is an outdated system, because right now I would be uncomfortable to go swimming. While swimming is one of the things that I love to do, I love swimming, I love being in the water. But I'm not gonna do that right now, because of the body hair. So I'm gonna start saving up for that. Weight and weight loss. In the last video, I was 122.9 kilos, which equates to 271 pounds. At moment of recording, I'm at 119.8 kilos, which translates to roughly 264 pounds. So I lost 3 kilos or 6 pounds in a month, which is amazing progress. That also means that I'm no longer in the morbidly obese category, which just puts me in the obese category. Still not a good place to be, but it's progress, and it's great progress for me because the last time I've been at this point was 5 years ago. I went back to where I was 5 years ago. I am so happy about this. How did I lose that weight? Well, there are two things that I actively use, and there's one thing that's always playing in the background. A year ago, I had therapy for my eating disorder. I was binge eating a lot. And in that therapy, I got to gain a new relationship with food, what is well, what is bad, and how that works. That is still playing in my head, and that put the groundwork for the other two things. One of those things is my fitness pal. Most of you know of my fitness pal. This is not sponsored by them. If only, somewhere in the past year, added a huge database of Dutch items. And they have a barcode scanner, which makes it a lot easier for me to track my calories. Combined with that, I use the Sculpt and Tone app. The Sculpt and Tone app gives me workouts that I can do easily from home, and combine the two, I can keep an eye on how much I'm eating and I can stay fit and healthy to burn my fat off, to increase my metabolism and to just get this progress done. So those two, if you're here for that content, check it out. Really, it helps. It works wonders. There is also the 75 easy concept that I'm taking along because I am still exercising 7 times a week. And what exactly is exercise? Well, exercise is anything that raises your heartbeat. So for me, that is the Sculpt and Tone exercises, but that's also cycling. There are days where I cycle only those 15 kilometers. And sometimes I go out of my way when it's good weather and I am doing a 30 kilometer ride. It's fun. I enjoy it and it really helps with taking the weight down. And now to get into the topic of names. There is going to be two things about this. There's going to be a personal story, but also a little bit of general. Why names matter so much for trans folk, for people like us. This is my own opinion. What is the most iconic thing that a person has? It's their name. That name is the coat hanger that everything you know about that person gets attached. So that name can mean a lot for that person. A name gives an association to a person, and that person in most cases is somebody you are saying goodbye to. You are no longer the person that is with that name. In order to break with that, most trans people choose a new name. And that's why it's so valuable that that name gets used, because the new name is synonymous for the new identity, the new phase of life that you're going through. My old name, for example, is associated a lot with certain things that I did to mask. I tried to grow a beard for a long time, and that's associated. Those images are associated with that name. My old name is also something that a lot of people have a masculine association with, and I want to get rid of that association. Because while at the time of that name, that association was okay, it's not who I am anymore, and it's not who I want to be. So I break with that name. If people keep using that name, that association never dies. There are going to be new people you meet, and if somebody misspeaks or somebody misgenders you, they're automatically going to think, wait, what happened there? Why did that happen? They might ask, you might have to explain. Only if you want to, don't feel obliged that you have to. And that is the whole point. We want to get rid of that. It's also the point why I didn't tell people at my new work my old name. And of course, people who have known you for a long time are going to have a harder time to get used to it, because force of habit. But for a trans person who uses a new name, that is one of the most important things. They have to affirm their new identity. If you keep using that old name, or you don't put in the effort to learn the new name, you are denying them their new identity. And I'm not saying everybody does it on purpose, but if you don't put in the effort, you are not putting in the effort to get to know the new person. Because every time they're around you, they get reminded of who they were. You still have the association with who they were. People around you are going to be reminded by the association you had of them before. The new identity is never going to manifest itself. It's never going to show itself. And the least you can do is try and try real hard to get that name in there. And I'm not saying that every cis ally has a problem with that. There are tons of people in my life who had a great time with it, who did amazingly. And to everybody out there who is seeing that video, thank you. But there are also people out there who are having a hard time. And yes, I get that it can be hard. Every time you use the old name, you hurt us and you remind us of who we were, not where we were going. If you don't start actively using our new name, you can never get used to our new identity, and you never can get to know us truly, which is sad, because we deserve to be known. We're great people, we're fun. As some viewers who might be a little bit more well read into trans stuff, I prefer to use old name instead of dead name. Why? Because yes, I don't use that name anymore, but it's not dead. Because that name is a part of me, of my past. And I am not dead. It's an old name that I've chosen to say goodbye to. And now I choose something new. That's why I use old name. If you have a negative connotation with your name, I totally get dead naming. I totally get the idea of a dead name. But for me, it's a part of who I was, and it's a part of who I am now, but not a part I choose to use anymore. Thanks to my girlfriend, I have been thinking about getting the name change official, because there's a process here and I'm going to talk a bit about it later. I know the first name that I want to go with, it's Jade. And I know the last name, I'm not going to tell you on the internet, but I also have a middle name. And I want that middle name to be something reminiscent of what it was. I still want to use it as a sign of respect to my dad who chose the name. It's a family name. But I don't want the name that it is now, because that's a very masculine name. I have been debating that for the past month, and so far I came up with two options. It's Julia and it's Nicole. And I like them, I like the sound of them, and I'm still thinking about it, because not everybody gets the chance to choose their own name. So it's something that you want to get right, it's something that you want to feel right. If you guys have any suggestions, any fun names, let them know down in the comments below, please. I'm open for suggestions. When I've made up my mind, I would have to get my name legally changed. And that process in the Netherlands is a 4-step process. Together with changing your name, you can also change your gender marker, which is good. We officially have M for male, F for female, and X you don't want that specified. The first thing you need in the Netherlands is a declaration of an expert. That's either a psychologist, that might be a physician, somebody who knows you and who knows your state of mind and knows what you're going through. Step two would be making an appointment at the place you were born, with the municipality, and getting it changed. Luckily, that isn't that much of an issue. Going from one end of the country to the other end is about 500 kilometers, because we're a very tiny country, so that's manageable. After that is done, it gets automatically updated, and in about a week you can apply for a new driver's license, new ID, new passport, anything that's government official. And the last step, step four, is notifying things like your bank, your insurance, anything that has personal information on you to get it changed. And for myself, I am planning to make it a fun weekend because I have to go to the city of Rotterdam. I was born there and it's gonna be fun. We're gonna make a weekend out of it, go to a hotel, do that really quick and then do something fun. Of course, when we're out of lockdown and when Corona is over, please everybody stay inside until you get your vaccination. Please, I wanna go somewhere again. Thank you. Thank you for watching to the end, everybody. It's been 9 months on hormones. Thank you for being here. Thank you for supporting me. If you like content like this, please subscribe down below. It really helps. And I will see all of you in my next video about Alan Turing. Bye-bye.